this video, I'm going to just show you how you'll go about doing test 3. This is in the trig sections, but this will also be the same for the pre-calc sections. It's all for all four of those classes. Right, what you're going to do is on the either from the home page, the modules page, or the quizzes, I'm going to choose the home page just because that's automatically what it's set to. Scroll down. If you go down past module 3, where test 3 review is, and right below it, you'll see three things in test 3 module. You'll see test 3. This symbol means it's a quiz. Right now I have it labeled as do not enter because there's not actually a test in there and you only get one chance at a quiz. Then there's a test 3 work. This is where you'll submit your work. And the final one, this is gonna be where I put your grade, the assignment I put, your test 3 grade. This one I'll rename test 3 grade after the video. But what you'll do to do test 3 is you'll enter the quiz, and I'll have it more clearly labeled when the test comes around that this is the one you enter. All right, upon entering, I'll have some instructions here on how to do the quiz. Basically, it will say do the work on your own paper, and you'll have so much time. I think 2 hours is a good amount of time because this is, like I said, the same length test I would have given you in class, which you have 75 minutes to do. And you'll click take the quiz. The first question is going to be an honor code question, which is going to state what you can and cannot do, can and cannot use. You should not share your test, your work with anyone. You should not, you know, those kinds of things. You have to show all your work, which is what I'm going to be grading you on anyway. That's what you have to submit. And then if you go over, well, you should hit true. By selecting true, you will admit, follow the honor code, but that's understood even if you don't hit true. The next question is going to be a question for the test link. Upload it as a PDF like the homework quizzes. I just have a random homework quiz here to kind of explain it. You click on the homework quiz or what's going to be the test to open it and open it like you normally would. I'm okay with you printing it out and filling out your work on here. The test will have the room like it normally would, but because you're timed and your printer might malfunction or whatever, you probably just want to write the questions down as you go. So you spend however long you do taking the test, or you have up to 2 hours, your timer's right here. And once you're finished with that, just hit the next, there's nothing here. Then it'll come to the last question that'll just tell you what to do once you're done with your test. So when you're done, you'll click submit the quiz. And where you enter your work, I have it described here, and it's also what I pointed out at the beginning. After you submit the quiz, it'll tell me what time you started the quiz and what time you submitted it. If you don't submit it or forget to, it'll automatically do it when your timer runs out. So you can't really get around that as far as your submission. But what you'll do is you'll go to test 3 work document or assignment in the test 3 module. And you know, I expect you to upload your work within a reasonable amount of time. I'm giving you 2 hours to do the test. You know, if you're uploading your work 10 hours or 5 hours out of test, I don't know what happened between that amount of time. So, you know, you should be able to upload it pretty quickly. Most of you, well, all of you will have had to at least upload it. The homework quiz 6, you'll see how you upload it. But please follow the directions here and do not email it to me. Only email me if you have some sort of critical issue and you cannot upload it for whatever reason. But once you finish, click submit the quiz. It'll tell you you're done, blah, blah, blah. You'll go back to the module or the home page. They are the same. Scroll back down to test 3 module, which is below the unit 3 module. Click on this test 3 work, and what you'll do, it'll tell you exactly this. Submit the assignment, and find all your pictures wherever they are. I had questions about issues. Does it work with JPEGs? So I don't really know what all these pictures are. I couldn't tell you at all, but this is a JPEG. And when I click submit the file, wait, that's one of the ones that was broken. Some of these aren't real pictures. Let's see if I can show you. I know it works with real pictures. I really don't know what these are. I guess I forgot to double check that. All right, well, the only place I really know where their pictures are right here. But you see it's a JPEG. If you click submit, it'll tell you it's submitted if you and all the documents you submit over here. If you accidentally don't submit everything, right, it'll tell me what time your submissions are, so I have everything there. You know, if you change your submission 15 hours later, I'll know that. Don't do that. But what it'll do if you have to add another file. So this time I'll use something totally different. You see it's not the same one. Some PDF. If you have to resubmit another file, what will happen is it'll only count the last one you submitted. So if you do have like 5 sheets and you only submit 4, click here to see the files you've already uploaded. Yours is going to be very different from mine, but it'll go down and look, these are what I've submitted. Well, I want to include both of them. And see if it actually lets me do that. Well, that's annoying. But anyway, the point is, if you forget to submit all your work, just come back here and click on all of them. If you have more than one, which you should, I don't think you can do the whole test on one side of a piece of paper, hit add another file and then upload them all. Hit add another file and keep going until you do all of them. I don't know the upper limit, but there's no way you'll hit it. Hit submit assignment. The more files you have, the longer it will take, but it'll tell you. So I hit 4 things and I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess I did 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, and once again, you can keep resubmitting, but it only counts your last submission, and I see the time of your last submission. Do not submit something very late. Now, let's say you didn't realize that you didn't submit one photo many, many hours later. Email it to me, what you missed. I'll know what you missed because it won't be in there, and then we'll work something out. But it can take PDFs, it can take JPEGs, I'm sure it can take other types of photos as well. You know, most of you probably have the Canvas app on your phone. So I'm not really too familiar with that specifically, but I'm sure if you take a picture on your phone, it's very easy to do this. If you don't have the Canvas app, you know, you take the picture on the phone, the easiest thing to do directly would be to email me, but I would rather have it put in here. So if you do email it to me, and that's the quickest way you can do that, just email it to me right away, but I also want you to submit them in here, because it makes it not insanely challenging for me to try to grade and trace all your papers. All right, but make sure you submit your work in here. Once you're done, you know, it's submitted. If you go out of here to lead page, and now it'll say my last submission. If I go back to this, it has it right there. I don't know if it saves it in your grade book on your end. Test 3 work. you look at the assignment, that's where you can see what you submitted. And then the last thing, once you submit them, I'll have them, I'll grade them. What I'm gonna do on my end is the test will be like the other ones. You'll see problems, points per problem. I'm gonna record how many points you get per problem. And I'll just total up and put the final score on here like I normally would. And then if you have any questions, that'll be easier for me to address with you. But the way this will work, as long as you submit your assignment where you're supposed to, which is in that test three work, it'll be saved there through the end of the semester, and we can always go back and discuss it. You know, why you got so many points on a problem or whatever. But if you email it to me, that's not going to last forever. I can't save emails forever. It'll get bogged down and lost. So if you have any questions, hopefully this cleared it all up. Like I said, the test will look like the normal test. You do not need to do anything different to practice it. And like I said, if there are any other questions, though, the test will become available Sunday at midnight. So when I say that, I mean Saturday/Sunday at midnight, the night of the 28th, the morning of the 29th, and it will be due 3 days later, the night of the 31st, the morning of the 1st, that midnight.